Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to Balotro here on the channel. Today, we're going to continue our adventures in trying to get our first E. Thank you all very much for all the support. We're going to stick with the yellow deck here because I feel like that is just going to be the way to go. Having ourselves $10 to start with. But if we end up, if it ends up not working out, then, you know, we can always switch decks. I just don't want to play a gimmick deck, you know? I want to make sure that if we do this, we're doing it with all the cards, all the suits, that sort of thing, because I feel like that's the only way to say it's, like, legit, you know, if you want to consider it legit that way. Just like hunting for the flush here, we are able to get it. So yeah, that's the plan here, and I do think that we will get it eventually. The last couple of runs, especially that last run, we were like one Joker card away from greatness. So I'm hoping that we end up getting something like that here. Starting off with Midas Mask. I absolutely love the Midas Mask. All face cards become gold cards when played. And, yeah, you know, we can go for an Arcana pack. I do love the Emperor card here. Get Empress and World. Neither one of these are all that great. Director's Cut, we can reroll the boss blind. I think I'd rather hold on to our money for now. Let's just see what he can get. We're going up against the Psychic. We can double our money right now with the Economy tag, but what's more important right now is that we get some play out of the Midas Mask. So let's go ahead and play the straight here just because we just flopped it. A couple points on the board. Now we want to mulligan hard here. By mulligan, I mean draw hard for face cards. So I don't care about the ace. We only want face cards here so we can turn them into gold. And of course, we get our other ace. And there we go. Let's increase the multi on the aces just for fun. There we go. So look at that. So Midas Mask is going to turn everything into gold. Now, ideally, what we would find, if we really want some good synergy, is Vampire. Vampire would be absolutely mega right now. Speaking of mega, we have Mega Arcana Pack here, but I'm going to go for the Buffoon Pack first. And, yep. Don't like either one of these. I guess I'm just going to take the 8 ball for now. Go for the Mega Arcana Pack. It's going to give us two choices. A Fool card, a Magician's card. Could make some lucky cards if we really, really wanted to. None of these are really fantastic, to be honest. I'm gonna turn this into a lucky ace. I know that I just overrode the Empress card, but that's fine. Make another Magician card. Shoot the Moon and Ballot, Hanging Chad. I absolutely love Hanging Chad. Shoot the Moon might be okay for now to power us through the early game. And also that kind of incentivizes us to hold on to the queens that we convert over to gold cards thanks to Midas Mask. So, but first things first, we have to actually turn them into gold cards, and hopefully we end up doing that. I'm gonna use the Magician on another ace here, and I'm gonna play the aces full over Jack so we can turn these into gold. But let's see if we can maybe get some more of those kings. Yeah, so there's the Queen of Clubs. We would want to turn this into gold eventually. Wow, okay. So I'm only doing this, I'm doing this as a quick, this is just a quick thing. I'm going to play the Queen, even though we're losing 13 multi. Actually, no, we can't do this because we have to play 5 cards. Never mind, don't listen to me. Let's just convert the Queen now. Because we're going to start holding on to queens here for Shoot the Moon. And remember, these don't have to score with Midas Mask. We simply just have to play them. So let's do that. Maybe we'll get lucky. Also, should have put the lucky cards over here for Hanging Chad. My bad. I kind of forgot that we had that. So, all right. Consumable Crystal Ball is going to give us +1. Consumable slot. I think it's always good value to do that, to be honest. So we might as well just do it now. Devious Joker and Smiley Face. Neither one of these really are going to do much for us. I mean, like, Smiley Face is good, don't get me wrong, but I'd rather not. Oh, we got the Flint coming up, so we got to be careful about that. Wow. Okay. So I'm going to play. Let's make sure the Lucky Aces are out this time. Let's play this King and Jack just to turn them into gold cards as well here with the Midas Mask. Hey, we got $20. Look at that, baby. And we also drew 3 pair. Look at us. I don't know how we always manage to do it, but you know what? That is the Invicta luck there. We got the eights to give us Mercury, which I guess we'll use it. I'm going to turn these into spades so we can get the ace high flush, and we can maybe get $3 out of this king. There we go. So we gained a lot of money there thanks to the lucky proc, thanks to a hanging Chad, and look who's back, a smiley face. Fortune teller. I mean, it's guaranteed multi. I don't like 8-ball, so we can buy both of these. Go for the Arcana pack here, because we want to be opening up tarot cards and using them. We can create another queen, a gold queen. Or we can turn it to a steel queen, which would go hand in hand with Shoot the Moon. It's probably wiser to turn this into a steel queen. I really hope that we get Vampire. I am going to turn it to a Steel Queen. It's just smarter that way. Let's not be stupid. Not be greedy. We have ourselves a Glass King, and I'm definitely going to take that. Okay, so we have the Flint coming up. We know that we're going to need to play some big time cards here. Get one Queen here. I don't care about the Trip 3s, to be honest. We want to be playing... Essentially, we want to be playing nothing but face cards right now. And yeah, that's some face cards. This is a weak discard. I don't want to discard just one singular jack. So I think what we do is we play the aces. Play the aces. We can play the queens now just to get them done. Just to turn them into gold here. And this is also going to get us the multi from Smiley Face. Well, so we might actually just go out here. Hopefully lucky card procs and we get another $20. We didn't. You get $9, though, from our gold cards. Jumbo Spectral. We'll use that in a second, because we may get Wraithed here. Okay, so we can Fool card. We can turn something else into Steel. Or we can use the Hangman. We can actually remove a lot of cards here. So let's use Hangman. And let's go ahead and use the Fool card to turn that into a Hangman. Going to get Fortune Teller up to 9. Yeah, Ouija, Incantation, man. I wish we had Vampire right now. Ectoplasm. We don't have anything that would be horrible to get. The worst one would probably be Midas Mask. And honestly, it could have been worse. Fortune Teller's fine. So we can actually get we can get Joseph J. Joker here as well. We have a lot of incentive to play face cards right now. Lots. All right, so we got the Flint here. Go ahead and just use the Hangman card now. This should be a pretty good amount of points here. Points, I mean chips. It's also going to go hand in hand and convert the face cards. And look at that. We get one straight. We're out. Level one straight. No problem. Economy looking really, really strong. Normally, I wouldn't be going for Jumbo Arcanas, but I think that this is one of those times where it's okay to. And I'm just going to keep trimming out of our deck here. Super card, get a strength card, Hermit's gonna double our money. It's perfect time here with us having $20. Half Joker, nah. And I really don't want to get rid of Midas Mask in case we find Vampire. You know, as soon as we get rid of Midas Mask, we're gonna get Vampire. Cloud Nine would give us a reason to get a lot of to add nines. Gonna get rid of Midas Mask, but you know it's coming. Just get ready to see Vampire. That's all I'm gonna say. It's all spade cards to debuff. We gotta remember that. And we want to be playing face cards here. Turn these into queens. Minus hand size is really hurting right now. Singular high card is not going to do anything. Even if it is a king. I want to see what this does. Okay, never mind. I severely underestimated the amount of multi we get from Smiley Face and Hanging Chad. Mega Buffoon, I think we gotta go for that. Okay, we got Blueprint. I think we get rid of Business Card here. I'm gonna take the Holographic Half Joker. Then Blueprint. Then we want Blueprint, I guess, to copy. You can have it copy Hanging Chad or Shoot the Moon. Get Planet Merchant. You can start maybe leveling up some high card here. Just go Emperor. Moon and Strength card. Doesn't really matter that much. High card. I'm gonna go ahead and buy the Justice card too, because remember we have extra consumable slot. Give me one more. Okay. There's a straight. Really do anything. Does it get plus 30 multi on this? Yeah. Not bad. Okay. So I think what we do is we move Blueprint to Hanging Chad. Then we just play a singular ace. This is gonna go with Half Joker. This should get us out easily here. And then it's gonna also proc twice. So I think that this is a good chance here. Maybe get a little extra money. That would be nice. Yeah, well, it didn't happen, but we did gain a lot of money here from the gold cards thanks to the Midas Mask. Celestial Arcana. All these are not great. None of these are great. God, I hate selling it because I want to use the fortune teller. We can at least get another jack out of this, I guess. We can use the Emperor. Feel me? None of these really gonna matter here. A pair deck might be okay with half Joker. Some discard's not bad. Rerolls are starting to get up there. We don't want to just nuke all of our early game economy here. So all spade cards are debuffed. Means that the queen won't matter. Okay, we at least got the ace. Let's play the queen. Or let's play the ace with the two queens here. I don't know. I mean, this is 40 multi right here. I think 40 multi with the ace of diamonds is going to be great. It's still going to trigger twice anyway, so this is probably better than copying shoot the moon, because this is only 26. This is 40. Well, hang on a second. This is 26. This is 20. Blueprint does not copy the holographic nature, I don't think. So it actually is better to copy shoot the moon. Let's do that. Do that. I'm going to get rid of the 7 just to get rid of it. Another queen, but unfortunately it's debuffed, so I'm going to do that. Pair of threes. They get us out for sure. This doesn't matter. But playing aces means that smiley face isn't really doing anything, so if we're going to be playing high cards, we want to be going for, definitely want to be going for face cards. But it's not like smiley face is huge, though. It's only plus 4 multi, so the trio with the half Joker could be pretty good. It is times multi, which is something we desperately need right now. Wily Joker, again, another three of a kind. Let's see what the Jumbo Standard Pack gives us. The queen. And take the queen. Hundred chips is quite a bit, but a face card is drawn face down. Not that big of a deal. Okay, so we want to see what our ace does here. I kind of want to trigger it twice, just take a gamble here. They are high cards, only level 2, so it's not good. Okay, I did nothing. The multi. Go, $12. Buffoon pack here, plus 1 discard, odd Todd. Now, Lucky Cat is something that I've been wanting to try to play with. We only have 2 lucky cards, though. I'm going to try this. If it doesn't work out, then that's fine. At least we could have some fun. We want lucky cards here, so well, $22 is pretty good. But Lucky Cat means that we need to get lucky cards. Guess we make a lucky 9. Need one more. Earl Bean. Hallucination is not bad either with Fortune Teller, but we just don't have room for it, so. There's a lucky card. Get rid of the Jack here. Maybe we can get another Queen. Okay, so we want the lucky card to proc here, and we're going to give it a second chance to do so because we want to get the lucky cat procing up. So it gains 20% multiplier every time the lucky card successfully triggers. So we want to try to get it give it much of a chance to do so as possible. For now, anyway. And it didn't trigger. Now we can go move Blueprint back over here to shoot the moon. Give us the biggest multi possible. I guess play is 7. Gonna get us there anyway. There we go. Hoping we see a Pluto here. Level up our high card. Not getting to crazy levels yet, but I do like a gold seal ace. Egg. First played face card gives x2 multi when scored. Problem is that it only is going to give it when it scores itself, so it's not going to be that much. Face cards are drawn face down. We can reasonably assume that one of these is a queen. We're about to find out, so let's just find out. These two are queens here. Go. No problem with the mark here on anti-5. Still just doesn't feel like we're scaling at all, though. I mean, we have very, very little multi, if any, right now. Gonna buy the blank just to have it, just because, again, I don't know exactly what that's gonna end up doing for us. Take our Arcana pack, we get to take 2. And $22 sounds good. Yeah, $22 sounds good. Okay, Jumbo Spectral. Let's hold off on that in case we end up finding a Wraith, because that's going to set our money back to 0. That doesn't mean that we want to blow all of our money here, because it's possible that we won't see it. But we definitely want to do a little bit of re-rolling here just in case. Smear Joker, misprint, doesn't really matter to me. Okay, now we're getting up to the really expensive re-rolls. Okay, Jumbo Spectral. So we get Hex. Immolate, Aura, and then Ectoplasm -2 hand size. Just sounds like a terrible idea. It destroys 5 cards in hand, we gain $20. Or we get a Polychrome, but destroys all our other Jokers, which is just also a bad idea. Let's hope that it selects these 5. It won't. It'll get these 4. Yeah. We got $20. We trim our deck even more, so. And, sure, give me the High Priestess. Guess we did not destroy any of our lucky cards here. Can't find any of our lucky cards. So I guess we don't have to play the Glass King here. But if we're gonna go out, we might as well go out with style, baby. 4 queens. Hey, it didn't break. Look at that. Got a lot of money too. Good. Okay. Pluto. My card's starting to get up there now. Nothing, again, nothing crazy, but I like how much we've trimmed our deck here. Jack of Hearts. I mean, it's got plus chips on it. That's fine with me. Cool card gives us another high card to use. Okay, Empress, you gotta go. That. Let's go ahead and use the High Priestess now. Neither one of these do anything for me, so I'm just gonna... I guess I'll use the Three of a Kind in case, but yeah, so I'll leave. Erosion's plus 4 multi for each card below 52. We have currently 28 multi there. So potentially that's probably better than Hanging Chad. We have done a lot of trimming here. Although I am going to miss having the I'm gonna miss having the plus the extra proc for lucky cards here. I don't want the ace. Get out of here. I want my lucky ace. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so I'm just gonna hold on to all this right now. And let's play the lucky ace first. Maybe this procs here. I'm gonna copy Lucky Cat just because I wanna see what I mean. It's just a 0.2 multiplier, but let's just see what happens with this. With the addition of erosion here. We have a lot of plus multi. Okay, it didn't proc. I'm gonna play the 9 now. No, it didn't proc. There you go. This one hand size is very good. Arcana pack. Another Temperance. Let's go ahead and make a Glass Ace. I'm tired of seeing that Justice card up there. Then we can just use the Temperance. Give us more money. Fortune Teller's starting to get up there on the multi. To the point where, like, I really don't think we need Erosion. I would much rather have the plus one hand size, to be honest. If we can get Lucky Cat rolling, man. This is a lot of plus multi. The plus one hand size allows us to hold on to more. Twenty-eight multi is a lot, but we don't really have a lot multiplying it as a thing, though. I'm gonna get rid of erosion. I want plus one hand size. Give me one more. For Michelle, would be awesome to get the Cavendish, to be honest. But I'm not gonna get rid of anything right now. We have the house. First hand is drawn face down. Okay, so this is aces. We don't know what these are. Play the ace and find out. See if we're holding on to any queens here. We're holding on to two queens, actually. So this is probably our lucky ace. Two queens is going to be 26 multi. It's 26 multi. I think this is our lucky ace here. It is. They're not proccing, though. I mean, I'm going to keep doing it. High card's still looking pretty good. Look at that, 15 extra dollars. Economy's smoking right now. So we gotta get that, we need to get that cohesion though across the Jokers. That's what we're lacking. We need something big here. Oh, Michelle. bear trousers, and the half Joker is 30 multi. We can't get rid of it. It's handsome. I'm gonna skip it. I can't get rid of it. Not yet. Gumbo's a scam. We got the wheel going here. Got our lucky card. All right, come on, lucky cat. Hey, there we go. Okay, it's good. Again. Oh. But still, just that tiny little, just 20% multi. Look how much it's scoring. I'm telling you, man. Oh, Invisible Joker. we got to take it. We cannot not take this. Sorry, Juggler. You know I love you, but
Invisible Joker.
Imagine two blueprints on Anti Six. I told Justin that I made that Invisible Joker Marilyn Manson connection, and he hates me for it because now he can't not make that connection here. I'm going to take the lucky diamonds, the lucky two of diamonds, just because we're trying to get something going with Lucky Cat here on Anti Six. It's too late, way too late to pivot now, but I mean, this has a feeling of something that might be happening. Get rid of one of the kings too. One of the queens. Hey, look at that. Rocked again. We got the lucky deuce. Give me that lucky deuce. Didn't proc. But look at that, just one deuce. A singular deuce that didn't even proc with a lucky proc, and we got out of that. I'm telling you, man. Fortune tellers, the multi's starting to get up there too. We can make another lucky card. I'm just gonna go ahead and do that. 28 on the multi for that. We get a justice card, which I will take. All right, 1 in 7 cards get drawn face down. I'm just gonna go ahead and play this now. And proc again. Come on, lucky cards. Got our ace. We got another queen, which is good. I'm gonna save the justice card in case we need to flip over a king. Celestial packs have the most played hand, which of course far and away is going to be high card here. I guess give me 20 bucks. Well, no. Let's use the Emperor card so we get two tarot cards here. I'm going to turn this to a glass ace. And hey, look at that. We got a magician card. Lucky us. Last king. I'm going to go ahead and use the star card now. Just so we can use fortune teller. gonna remove the glass and turn it lucky. Then I'm going to make another lucky king. I'm trying my hardest to make this work. I don't know if it's going to or not, but I'm gonna try my best. At 35 bucks here, which is pretty good. Got the mouth coming up. I think we're gonna be fine with that. And Invisible Joker is gonna be done next turn, so. Wow. Okay. Yeah, that's it's 52 multi. Which is probably better than times 1.6 maybe. Gonna be a lot of multi here. Hey, Proct. And we'll just play the ace. Let's just see. I still think actually multiplying the lucky cat's gonna be just better. Yeah, way better. All right, Invisible Joker is procced. Now what do we do? Oh, man. The only one we really don't want it... We don't want it copying is probably Half Joker. Lose 33 multi. You can also just YOLO it and just see what happens. Two blueprints on a lucky cat won't do anything. We need four jokers to actually have any sort of... Get rid of Shoot the Moon. You don't lose much. Shoot the Moon would also be not one of the ones that I would like really care about right now. I'm okay with losing Shoot the Moon. I'm okay with losing Half Joker. Even though that's 30 multi. I'm okay with that. We can use the Judgment card now to see if we can get something useful, and if we don't, we can just sell it. Then we can also use the Buffoon Pack here. Don't care about Runner, so that can go. Buy the Buffoon Pack. Both of these are not great. I'm going to take Spare Trousers and then just sell it. Okay. I'm going to buy the Hangman. Moon again. All right. Let's see which one it copies. I'm hoping, obviously, we want Blueprint here. Copied Fortune Teller. Okay, it wasn't negative, so I was tripped out. That was definitely the worst out of the three. It's still plus 34 multi, and then every single tarot card that we end up using is going to add 2 multi. So it definitely could have been worse, but it could have been a lot better too. Okay, so we don't have to worry about holding on to queens anymore. We can trim eights if we wanted to. Obviously, we still want to hold the queens for money, though, because we just nuked all of our economy. Play the ace. No, we need to go hard for. We need our lucky cards now. Burn that. Sell that. Hey, look at that. Okay. Let's hope that we get some procs here. Did not. Hope that we get some procs here. There we go. One more time. Hey, Lucky Cat's a 2 multi, so. Seltzer. I'm going to buy Seltzer because this could potentially give us a lot of lucky procs. Ooh, black hole. Upgrade all hands. Might as well do it. It's a steal 3 of diamonds. Alright, so obviously we want to only play high cards here. We did draw the steal 3, which is fine. Okay, we got 4 lucky cards here. So let's play the king first, and again we want to re-trigger all cards played. Does that mean if I play all of these, they're all going to re-trigger? Re-trigger all cards played for the next 10 hands. Find out. If the queen goes, then that means that it will also trigger the rest of the lucky cards. Let's find out. Okay, so it's only the ones that score, not played. So that needs to be reworded a little bit. Ace. Kill me. Hey, nice. Roll surplus. Get that high card up here. The lucky card. I mean, I'm not gonna take it. Always forces one card to be selected. Cerulean Bell is pretty bad. But we can play quad kings here, and these lucky cards will play, so. Let's do that. I like that. Hope that it procs. Hey, nice. Okay, Lucky Cat's at 2.6 now. Got a gold and polychrome joker. Go ahead and take that. We'll go ahead and take the reroll surplus. And we need to make a little bit of money on the next turn so we can reroll the boss. Strength card, we can turn these into queens. And turn them into kings. Kings do we have? We have 6 kings. Or just level up high card, which I'm probably going to end up doing. Let's turn these into queens. It's fine. Okay. So we need to make $3 to reroll the boss here. to hold on to the queens. We want to hold on to the lucky cards too. Possible. Polychrome Joker is going to be very, very nice. Only doing this just so we can get a double proc on the lucky here. It's not gonna go the way that I wanted unless we get a flush. We could try to draw for a diamond here. And that could allow us to get double trigger on the lucky cards. We got it. Look at that. Nice. Okay. Down for that. Oh, the deuce procced. Lucky cat at 2.8 now. We wanna re-roll the boss blind. They are both not great, but hey, we got Pluto. Okay, there's no reason to re-roll because we need to re-roll the boss blind. So I'm gonna re-roll it now, and we get very large blind, 300,000. Seltzer is still good. Got to make a hand here. Wow. Okay. We're going to copy Lucky Cat. Hope that the ace procs here. Didn't. 190,000 though, good lord. Oh, I didn't mean to play the four. Didn't I? Interesting. I think we'll just go ahead and play this one out, even though we're not scoring huge right now. If we ended up having like oops all sixes, I think that we would be absolutely smashing this one. So we're going to run this one out here. Driver's license does play with times three multi on that. Seltzer's going to be gone in two hands. Ooh, we can also get Hieroglyph here, which allows us to redo the last floor, and I'm definitely going to do that. Driver's license gives us guaranteed times three multi. Gonna get rid of Seltzer, even though it has two more re-triggers left for driver's license. So we have a lot of plus multi, and we have a lot of times multi now. So we're gonna keep opening up tarot cards. This is gonna keep on feeding fortune teller times two. Go ahead and get a $26 play here. I'm gonna turn that into a lucky card here, because again, I'm trying to build the multis on Lucky Cat. Crimson Heart, that's fine. You don't understand, we want our lucky cards. Let's see what a level 12 high card does here with us copying the driver's license now. Hey, it procced. The lucky cat's now times three. Wow. Okay. Well, we got some scaling now. Strength card we could definitely use. The strength card just because. And we can make a chariot. Make a steel card here. 43 multi. That's 86 multi now. No, we can always get a Pluto out of a Celestial, so that's good. Magician, I'm gonna take it. And I do like hanging Chad. I'm gonna turn this into a lucky ace, and then I'm gonna play two pair here. Just so we can get all four of these played in one hand. Hey, nice. Wow, okay, so Lucky Cat is now outperforming Driver's License. Pluto's good. So we can start copying Lucky Cat instead of Driver's License now. We don't want any of those. Or any of those, okay. One random Joker is disabled every hand. They have a blueprint. Steal three. Gonna play this first. Okay. Pluto again. Definitely want overstock. Give me a Mega Buffoon. Nothing. No repeat hand types. I think we should be okay on that. Okay, we're going to play our ace. $1 million here. Want to keep opening up Arcana packs as well. Are these in aces? Ah, give me a wheel. Aww. Plus 90 now. Those multis. Card. Wheel me. Hey! We got a plus 10 multi. Look at that. Holo blueprint. Love it. Okay. Gonna play the ace. We have ample opportunities to ball out of control here. All we gotta do is just get some procs from our lucky cards. Imagine we had Campfire. Mega Celestial doesn't really matter to us, but I'm gonna keep opening and keep updating Pluto here. I guess Flush. Not that we'll ever use it, but you never know. No repeat hand types, so we need to make sure that if we're gonna play, we gotta play hard here. Okay, we got our steel three, that's good. Could play a boat. Just so we get try to get two lucky procs here. I think I like that. This isn't going to score anything for points, but... Yeah, we didn't get any procs. And we still beat it. The level one... A level one full house. Blackboard doesn't do anything for us. We already, I think, I don't see, I get to the spot and I don't know where we need to be at this point. Really, the Golden Joker is the weak link here. With only a times, the only reason why we have it is because it's just times one and a half multi, that's it. The window, all diamond cards are debuffed. We'll be okay without that. Gonna turn this 10 into No, we don't need to use that yet. These two are steel. I mean, really the only thing that we're looking for at this point is gonna be like oops all sixes. So maintaining a good amount of money. Pluto here. Planet Tycoon. I mean, I don't think we really need that, to be honest. Okay, Death card. Create another lucky king. I like that. Actually, let's create another lucky ace. Create a jack here. And we can create a lucky ace. So this is just another way that we're trying to, we're basically trying to create our own scaling, even though I still don't believe that we're going to get anywhere far. We've gotten a lot further than I thought we would, to be honest. I'm just going to be totally 100% honest on that. I didn't think that this run would last this long. And honestly, I'm kind of proud of it. I think we've done a pretty admirable job at making a build here, even though it is certainly not optimized at all. Hey, wow, I got 20 multi and the $20. Holy moly. And it gave us Pluto. Feel me? Hey, holographic again. Getting lucky on the wheels, man. High card getting up to level 19 now. I guess a glass jack is fine. A steel card, we might as well just take that. Okay, all diamond cards are debuffed. If it ain't lucky, we don't want it. Two lucky cards here. We can play two pair. This is I'm only playing this for the lucky procs here. I'm only playing this for lucky procs. This is not going to proc, but I just want to get it out of the inventory. I'm hoping that this procs. None of them procced. Okay. Pair of aces. We could play both of those and again, hope that one of them procs, at least for Lucky Cat. Get the 3.8. Either one of them. Observatory would be amazing, but what was that? Antimatter. Plus one. We just get a Joker slot. It just gives us a Joker slot, brother. Okay. I'm going to use the Fool so we get double use. So if we use the Fool, instead of using the Hermit card now, this is going to give us two procs on Fortune Teller instead of one, because first it's going to convert the Fool, and that counts as one, and then we use the Hermit card, that counts as another. That's the first time I've ever seen antimatter, and I'm... Hey, welcome to the party. I just ask again. Yeah. Scholar, you know what I want? I want Hanging Chad back. Where's my Hanging Chad at? Ice cream. I mean, we could buy it, I guess. Feel me? Okay. Now, what if we copied... Oh, it's not compatible. Dang. Okay, that's fine. So we got, we did get oops all sixes. Okay. Got my attention here, game. Feel me? So Fortune Teller's up to 60 each now. I'm just going to play this boat just so we have these. Let's see if oops all sixes can make a difference here. Yep. Yep. Absolutely. And now we start playing, just the lucky cards by themselves. Nice. Double proc on that as well. 10 million for high card. I mean, again, it ain't bad, you know? Judgment. Give me High Priestess. I don't think we're going to get past Anti 11, but I could be wrong. 22 high card now. Where are we at on this blind here? Okay, it's got the tooth. Got to get past 14 million. That shouldn't be a problem. Feel me? You like Hanging Chad, man. Okay. I'm going to get rid of the Golden Joker for Hanging Chad. Especially now with Oops All Sixes, that has a huge potential to let us get double procs out of our lucky cards. Udo? Throw back, nah. It's another boat. Again, I'm only doing this because I'm trying to maximize the potential of us proccing these lucky cards here. And we know that the ace is going to play twice because of Hanging Chad. Okay. Lucky cast now at 4.8. Okay, now we chill. Now all we do is just play the ace. Now we just chill. Should get out of this along with these three steel cards. That should be massive here. Wow, double proc. Look at that. Lucky Cat to 5.2. Go to level 24. don't think Turtle Bean does anything for us. Temperance, definitely use that. And we're coming up against the mouth, and it's going to be 14.4 million. Haven't discovered this yet, but I don't care. Find the devil card so we can use it immediately. Use up our multis again. Hangman and Magician, we both can use these. I should say we can both use those. I'm getting excited here. So, get out of here. Lucky me. Okay. I think we just roll with high cards. We're gonna lose $1 per card play. We have the potential to make that money back just from the lucky cards. As a proc up to 5.4 now in the multi. Yeah, I'll take $3 twice. Lucky card didn't proc, but look at that. We get one more roll too. That's so good. I don't know why I played the four, but wow, absolutely smash anti 11. So again, we're not hitting E, but we're having fun. I can't use that, sorry. 71 multi. Who would have thought that tarot card would be just balling out of control like this? Overstock plus one card slot available in the shop. Gosh. A lot of cards. Plus 300 chips. Hand size doesn't really matter. But what do we get rid of? We can't really get rid of much. Is 300 chips with all this multi gonna be worth it? That's a lot. I'm gonna buy Stuntman just to see what this does. Oh, we got a new voucher unlock. Must be for all. No, I don't know. 300 million. This is where I think things end. But you never know. Oh, we got one of our steel cards. Okay, let's just send it. Let's see what 300 chips does. $13 million, Lucky Cat up to times 6. Yeah, we lack the exponential growth, though, is the thing. Well, you know what? We didn't light up the scoreboard, but I tell you what, that was one of the most engaging, interesting decks that we've come up with so far. I think that given our scaling, what would have helped us out the most for something like that, we would have to get some held in hand abilities, like the Baron. Baron Mime would absolutely blow that entire deck out of. I mean, that may have gotten it. Even if we just got the Baron, I think that copying the Tarot Merchant wasn't the worst thing that could have happened. Well, I mean, it was the worst thing at the time, but it ended up helping us out tremendously, I think. And we also beat Anti 11, which has always been kind of like the stop for me. So I'm happy with that. Very long video. I'm going to end it there. Thank you for watching, everyone. Remember, if you'd like to see more Balatro content here on the channel, click the like button. I would appreciate it. Get these videos over 1,000 likes, and don't expect these videos to be over 1 hour long. This one was just so interesting that I wanted to play it out and not make you wait 2 days. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.